This week, at Interior. It was the official handoff from NASA to the U.S. Geological Survey of the Landsat 8 Earth-observing satellite. Landsat rocketed into Earth orbit in February under the watchful eyes of NASA controllers and scientists from the USGS. Now USGS will assume full operational responsibilities.
You know, we do what each of us does best. NASA designs and builds great spacecraft and satellites. The USGS does a great job of synthesizing large amounts of data and turning it into useful information that is hugely impactful to the American people and how we take care of this planet that we all care so much about.
Landsat 8, as it will now be known, carries on a long tradition of Landsat satellites that for more than 40 years now have helped us learn how Earth works, understand how humans are affecting it, and make wiser decisions as stewards of this planet.
Also this week, the future of the Colorado Basin. Assistant Secretary for Water and Science Ann Castle joined Bureau of Reclamation Commissioner Michael Connor for a stakeholder meeting in San Diego. The event, called Moving Forward, aimed to identify the next steps called for by the Colorado River Supply and Demand Study, which was issued last December.
What the study shows us is that we have to do more. And we have to do more together. Saying that we're all in this together isn't just a sort of tired and shopworn cliche. In this case, it happens to be absolutely true.
Secretary Jewell joined the Student Conservation Association and the New York City Parks Department this week at Gateway National Park to announce that Interior will fund 200 youth summer jobs for New York and New Jersey park cleanup in the wake of Superstorm Sandy, all thanks to recovery and restoration funding. After the announcement, Secretary Jewell joined students at Reese Beach in Queens to continue the cleanup efforts there. Secretary Jewell joined National Park Service Director John Jarvis and Rhode Island Senator Jack Reed this week at the John H. Chaffee Blackstone River Valley National Heritage Corridor. The trip highlights the economic and recreational value of national parks, wildlife, refuges, waterways, and other public lands in advance of National Trails Day on Saturday, June 1st. The annual National Trails Day occurs on the first Saturday of June. It's the country's largest celebration of trails and includes hikes, biking, horseback riding, paddling trips, bird watching, and geocaching. To find out more about trails in your area, check out AmericanHiking.org. That's this week at Interior.